a little bit about forest ecosystems, and these are analogous to any other terrestrial or on land ecosystem that we would discuss. So in this example ecosystem, such as a forest, there's a lot going on. So in this system, the NEP, net ecosystem production, is the total increase of biomass in the whole system. The RE is total respiration, and that's respiration that's taking place by the trees and the grass, by animals that are eating the trees, and by organisms that are decomposing dead trees. So an example here is the stump that's decomposing in the ground. That's being done by microbes, and they're also respiring. So there's a lot of respiration going on that's kind of unseen or things we don't think about. Another example is there's a lot of little tiny animals that live in the soil and underground that we don't see, but they are also respiring. Gross primary production, GPP, in this system and all systems, this is done by plants or producers. So they really do all the hard work for an ecosystem because they're the ones that are harvesting, or not harvesting, but harnessing this energy from the sun and converting it into all the biomass that we see in the ecosystem. So without them doing that hard work, the other life would not exist. So NEP is what we can measure that in terms of an increase in biomass over time. Respiration, we can measure by looking at how much carbon dioxide is generated, especially if we just measure it at night so that we're not worried about how much is being taken up in the process of photosynthesis. And GPP is harder for us to measure in these systems, which is why we tend to measure the other two, and then from these, we calculate GPP. So just to recap, plants that are in the forest harness that solar energy. They convert it to plant sugars through a process called photosynthesis, and this is what accounts for GPP, or gross primary production, which provides energy for all of the life that's in that forest ecosystem. So if plant life in the forest is growing, and life in general in the forest is growing, there will be an overall increase in biomass, and in this case, net ecosystem production, NEP, is going to be greater than zero. This is not true in all ecosystems. So there are ecosystems in which a forest, for example, might be dying. So the trees might be very old on average, and they're starting to die. And in this case, they're not harnessing energy from the sun as fast as it's being decomposed in the forest. And in this case, NEP would be less than zero. So it isn't always positive, but anytime you have a growing ecosystem, NEP is going to increase and be more than zero. So in a forest ecosystem and all terrestrial ecosystems, when we think about respiration, who does respiration? Everything in that ecosystem is respiring, everything that's alive. So rocks aren't respiring, but every living thing is respiring. So that includes all the plants, all the animals, and then all of the microbes in the soil that are decomposing plant litter and plants that are dead and decomposing. So in this ecosystem, NEP, we can measure change in biomass equals GPP minus RE, and we can measure respiration at night. And so then we can determine GPP.